Welcome back, JCC. We're continuing on in Chapter 11, Stoichiometry. We are going to do a typical mass-mass stoichiometry problem now. And up here is kind of the map for doing these problems. See, we just did mole ratios, but when you're in the lab, you don't go measure out moles on the balance, right? Balances don't measure moles. They measure grams or pounds, but in chemistry, we use balances that measure in grams. So in reality, we're going to start off with grams of a chemical. But to use a mole ratio, you have to be in moles. So the first step is to convert our grams that were given to moles of that given substance. Now remember from the last chapter, every time you go from grams to moles or moles to grams, you use a molar mass. Where do you find that molar mass? You're correct if you said the periodic table. The molar mass is in the periodic table. So we use molar mass to go from grams that are given to moles that are given. Then we can use our mole ratio and switch substances from the moles of the given substance to the moles of the substance we're finding. But having moles isn't going to help us because we can't go measure that out on a balance. So now we need to switch this moles back to grams for the second chemical or substance in the problem using the molar mass, again, from the periodic table. So we're going to do grams to moles to grams. All right, here's our balanced reaction. 3 FeO solid plus 2 aluminum solid will produce 3 iron solid plus Al2O3 solid. So this reaction is already balanced for you. Let's look at our first question. Calculate the mass of iron 2 oxide needed to react completely with 5.55 grams of aluminum. So we have two chemicals. Iron 2 oxide and aluminum, two chemicals. What chemical is iron 2 oxide? Well, it would have iron and oxygen in it, so it must be the FeO. So we need to find grams of FeO needed to react with 5.55 grams of aluminum. So that's what we're going to start with, 5.55 grams of aluminum, and we're going to grams of FeO. So let's work this step by step. Grams to moles. What do we need to go between grams and moles? A molar mass. We need the molar mass of aluminum. So we have 5.55 grams of aluminum. Find aluminum. There it is. One mole of aluminum is 26.98 grams of aluminum. What's on the bottom, moles or grams? Well, we started with grams, so we need grams on the bottom. So it looks like that. One mole of aluminum over 26.98 grams of aluminum. Now we have our moles to do the mole ratio. So we're going to do the mole ratio between the two chemicals of aluminum and FeO. Which mole needs to be on the bottom? Well, the aluminum, so it'll cancel out. How many aluminums are in this balanced reaction? Two moles of aluminum. And we're converting to FeO. How many moles of FeO are in this reaction? Three moles of FeO. So there's our next step. 3 moles of FeO over 2 moles of aluminum. So moles of aluminum cancel out and we're done with the aluminum. We have switched chemicals to FeO using this mole ratio. So now we have moles of FeO, but we need grams of FeO. How do we go between moles and grams? Molar mass. How do we find the molar mass of FeO? Well, in our periodic table, we're just going to add up one Fe and one O, and that will give us the grams of FeO. Will that grams be on top or bottom? Well, It's not what's canceling out, so it'll be on top. And we add up one FeO, right? Not three, but one. Just add up one of them. So it's one mole of FeO and then the grams of FeO that we add up. And that step looks like this. The one mole of FeO needs to be on the bottom so moles of FeO can cancel out. And when you add up one Fe plus one O, you get 71.85 grams of FeO. So let's double check our units. Grams of aluminum cancel, moles of aluminum cancel, moles of FeO cancel. We're left with grams of FeO, and that's what the question asked for grams of iron to oxide. So we punch this all into our calculator and we get 22.2 grams of FeO. You just did your first stoichiometry problem. These are long problems, right? They're three-step problems. You did very good. Let's go back to the previous slide real quick and look at the second question right there. Calculate the mass of aluminum oxide produced when 10.25 grams of aluminum react completely. So we have two chemicals again, aluminum oxide and just aluminum. Two chemicals and a balanced reaction means it's stoichiometry, which means there's a mole ratio in there. Just like we learned before, if it's a stoichiometry problem, there's a mole ratio in there. This time we're starting with 10.25 grams of aluminum, but we're going to grams of aluminum oxide. Which chemical above is aluminum oxide? Well, it would have aluminum and oxygen in it, so it must be Al2O3. So that's what we're trying to find. Let's go back now to number two. We are starting with 10.25 grams of aluminum. We need to get to a mole ratio, so we need to change that grams to mole. How do we change grams to moles? Molar mass, yeah. The molar mass of aluminum again, right there. 26.98 grams in one mole. Remember, a molar mass is always one mole. A molar mass is always one mole. Add up one mole. So the first step looks just like it did in the last problem. One mole of aluminum over 26.98 grams of aluminum. Grams of aluminum cancel. Our next step is the mole ratio. We are going from aluminum to aluminum oxide. How many aluminums are in the reaction? Two, right? Two moles of aluminum. Will that be on the top or the bottom? You're right if you said on the bottom. What's on top? Moles of the Al2O3. And how many Al2O3s are there? Just one. So the mole ratio looks like this. One mole Al2O3 over two moles of aluminum. Moles of aluminum cancel. We have switched chemicals to aluminum oxide because we do that when we have a mole ratio. Last step, we need to go from moles to grams. How do we go from moles to grams? Molar mass. So we need to add up two aluminums and three oxygens. Add that up. Again, you just add up one of them. One molecule of Al2O3. Add it up. That'll be the grams per one mole of Al2O3. Is the grams on top or bottom? Hopefully you said top, and it looks like this. If you add that up correctly, you get 101.96 grams of aluminum oxide over one mole of aluminum oxide. Let's double check our units. Grams of aluminum cancel, moles of aluminum cancel, moles of Al2O3 cancel. We're left with grams of Al2O3. That's what we want. Put it into your calculator, and we get 19.37 grams aluminum oxide. Four sig figs, right? Our original number had four sig figs. The molar mass of aluminum has four sig figs. Mole ratios are exact. the molar mass of aluminum oxide actually have 5 sig figs, but we go with the least, which was 4, so 19.37 grams. All right, good job. Have a great day, GCC. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.